Welcome to Eaton's installation tutorial for our dual sliding end of row door. Before installing an Eaton dual sliding end of row door, it is recommended that you familiarize yourself with the various door components and tools required as described within our installation document found on our website, www.eaton.com/EORD. Please also review the best practices, safety suggestions, and helpful hints. We strongly recommend at least two people work together to install the door and they use the proper personal protection equipment. Chapter 1. Prepare the site. Measure out 2 inches from each electronic rack and place marks on the floor. Mark 2 points on the line 48 inches apart to designate the desired position for the door opening width. Chapter 2. Assemble the jamb walls. Attach a track extension to the wall with 2 hex head self-threading screws. Pre-install 2 hex head self-threading screws into the transom attachment holes on each wall. Leave the screws protruding about 1/8 inch. Pre-install a hex head self-threading track cover screw into the attachment hole in the track extension. Leave the screw protruding about 1/8 inch. Attach a vertical door seal channel to the wall using 3 hex head self-threading screws. Position the channel with the screw centered in the slots. Attach 1 bracket to the face of the wall with 2 hex head self-threading screws. Secure the bracket in its highest position. Install rubber gasket along back edge of transom. Chapter 3. Assemble the transom. Attach 2 track brackets to the transom with 8 hex head self-threading screws. Attach the top door seal channel to the transom with 3 hex head self-threading screws. Position the channel with the screws centered in the slots. Pre-install 2 hex head self-threading screws into the center track cover holes in the face of the transom. Be sure to leave the screws protruding about 1/8 inch. Chapter 4. Erect and secure the jamb wall assembly. Ensure that the wall's leveling feet are fully retracted. Then stand the right-hand jamb wall and align with the line on the floor that defines the door's opening width. Loosely attach the right-hand jamb wall to the top of the electronic rack enclosure with an enclosure bracket. Attach the bracket to the enclosure with appropriate fasteners. Attach the bracket to the wall in the most optimum position with 4 hex head self-threading screws. Repeat these 2 steps with the left-hand jamb wall assembly. Engage the transom assembly onto the pre-installed transom attachment screws. Tighten the transom attachment screws. Install a tie bar into the top of the jamb wall assembly at each transom to wall interface with 4 hex head self-threading screws. Verify that the jamb wall assembly is level, planar, and aligned with the marks on the floor. Then tighten the enclosure bracket screws. Lower the floor anchor brackets to the floor and then attach the brackets to the floor with the appropriate fasteners for the site. Failure to properly secure the jamb wall assembly to the electronic enclosures and to the floor will result in a potential tipping hazard, which can cause serious injury. Chapter 5. Install the door tracks. Prepare the door tracks. Install the remaining track brackets by attaching a track bracket to each jamb wall with 4 hex head self-threading screws. Attach a door hold open retainer to the right end of one door track and to the left end of the other door track. Use one Phillips pan head self-threading screw for each retainer. Install the door tracks. Loosely attach the left-hand door track onto the track bracket studs with 2 1/4-20 hex caps nuts. Loosely install 1 1/4-20 by 1/2-inch hex head self-threading screw into the track extension. Install 1 1/4-20 by 3-inch Allen head track adjustment screw into the track's threaded insert. Then turn the adjustment screw to incline the door track until the track's alignment hole aligns with the hole in the track bracket. Then tighten the 3 track attachment fasteners and repeat this procedure for the right-hand door track. This incline is 1/2 degree, which should result in a moderate initial self-closing door speed. The closure speed will be fine-tuned during the end of the installation process by adjusting this angle. Chapter 6, Install the Doors. Attach the handle to the door and secure the screw cover into the handle. Insert 2 large hole plugs into the screw access holes. Repeat this process for the right-hand door. Hang the doors. Have one person position the door while a second person loosely attaches the door from inside the aisle with 2 Allen head screws and 2 washers. The handle edge of the door is attached to the hanger plate at the pivot hole. The opposite side of the door attaches to the plate at the oval adjustment slot. Install an Allen head door adjustment screw in the door hanger plate near the jamb wall. Seat the screw head against the door's top frame member. Using a 5/32 Allen wrench, turn the door adjustment screw until the door is level. Then tighten the door attachment screws. Repeat this procedure for the right-hand door. Rotate the left-hand door guide into place below the door, inserting the guide pin into the channel in the bottom of the door. Attach the door guide to the wall with 2 hex head self-threading screws. Repeat this procedure for the right-hand door guide. Apply D-bulb gasket to the mating edges of each door. Starting at 1 3/4 inch from the top of the doors, apply the gasket along the entire height of the doors. Stagger the gasket positions as shown in graphic. Attach 1 door alignment tab to the inside of each door using 2 Phillips flathead self-threading screws for each alignment tab. With the doors closed, check to ensure that the doors are level and vertically aligned with each other. If required, loosen the 2 Allen head screws on the adjustable door guides and adjust the guide pins in or out to align the faces of each door. Chapter 7, Adjust the Door Perimeter Seals. Adjust the position of the vertical door seal channels so that their contact surfaces barely touch the pile gaskets on the doors. Adjust the position of the top door seal channel so that the pile gasket barely touches the rear door surface. With the doors fully closed, adjust the position of the bottom door seal channels so that the pile gaskets barely touch the floor. When properly adjusted, the door perimeter seals should not hinder the self-closing speed of the doors. Chapter 8. Adjust Door Automatic Closure Speed. Open each door fully and then allow the doors to self-close. The door closure speed should be as slow as possible while still ensuring that the doors always fully close. While the doors may rebound slightly, they should be adjusted so that they always return to their fully closed position. Adjust the incline of each track as required by loosening the track's three adjustment points and then turning the track adjustment screw. Retighten the three track attachment points when the desired closure speed is attained. If the track incline is adjusted, it may be necessary at that point to loosen the door attachment screws to re-level the door. Chapter 9. Install covers. To install a track cover, position the cover onto the top of the track brackets, engaging the keyhole slots at each end of the cover with the previously installed screws. Install two hex head self-threading screws into the track brackets to secure the cover. Insert the hooks on the covers into the slots in the door. Push the cover upwards to seat the hooks. Secure each cover with one Phillips pan head self-threading screw. Attach the inner transom cover to the transom with eight Phillips pan head self-threading screws. We have completed the installation of Eaton's dual sliding end of row door.